The temperature is presently 88 degrees, humidity 86. Forecast from the Naval Observatory indicates fair skies and a warming trend throughout the next 3 days.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, pal.
And now, Radio Singapore returns you to Claude Jones Smith and the morning music cavalcade.
Music to sweat by. Just what I need. Go on, take it.
Whoa, fella.
That's it.
Oh, how did you get out of this basket? Here.
Steady, fella. Steady, we're all friends here.
Frank, I need your help.
Gloria, grab that basket. Quick. Come on, hurry up. Take the lid off.
Yeah, now set it right down here.
Stand back.
Yeah. There we go.
Thanks for the distraction.
Listen, I'm going down to the dock to meet Princess Katia of Kujwar. And I thought maybe you'd introduce me since you know her so well.
Look, Gloria, I'd love to help you, but I gotta get this cobra and 100 animals on a steamer before sundown.
So you're not going to meet the princess?
But yeah, for dinner. With H.H.,
if I can get this work done.
Well, maybe you'd have more time if you didn't waste it playing with that snitch.
Playing.
Well, my late cousin Saeed seems to have left his affairs in order. As his brother and Lord Protector, you have handled his affairs well, Hamidi.
Thank you, Your Highness. I merely wish Princess Kati to inherit a solvent kingdom along with her crown.
You did well. I realize it was no mean task. Until his illness of last year, Saeed's only interests were horses and women, not necessarily in that order. Well, I must fly if I am to meet Princess Kati.
But it's not necessary for you to make that long and dusty trip. Marisi, Kati's handmaiden, and Captain Hayward of the Guard are going to Singapore to welcome her.
It has been 4 years since I've seen my princess.
Well, the more the merrier. Her tutor, Tadid, I had thought to take him along. He was always one of her favorites.
Sadly, after the Sultan's death, Tadid went into seclusion.
We can put you up comfortably here, Your Highness. It is a tiresome journey. It is prescribed the coronation must take place at noon of the holy day. That's less than 48 hours.
You're very kind, but I would never forgive myself if I weren't there to welcome Princess Kati back to Singapore. Excuse me.
Any trouble with His Highness?
He insists on meeting the princess himself.
Well, I can handle him. In any event, the princess's death will appear to be an accident. You'll wear your brother's crown, never fear.
It's the Sultan of Johor.
Captain Hayward, it's Tadid.
Well, get after him. Don't just stand there. He mustn't reach the Sultan.
Highness, Your Highness, they're going to kill the princess. You must...
Oh, save her.
Let's go, girl.
Hurry for him.
What is the Sultan of Johor?
Yes, get him. The horses, quickly.
Come, get to the horse.
Tadid must have told him. You must bring him to ground and kill him.
Not I, Hamidi, you. I have an appointment with the princess, remember? I suggest you use a rifle. It should improve your aim.
Don't let him get away! All right, right here. Now, time down good. You got away on me this morning, had me really dancing.
Well, you better be doing a two-step on the dock, Buck. You know, that load of animals we have on the big truck, that new customs inspector, Samuelson, he's going through it with a fine-tooth comb.
That's why I have you around, Ali. Sweet-talk him just like you do all the others.
Me, sweet-talk Samuelson? Buck, I'd rather kiss a camel.
And a kiss it is, because I've got to be ready when H.H. gets here. I'm having dinner with a princess tonight.
Swell.
I can't stick around.
All right. Be careful with him here.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Buck! Buck! Buck, we've got to stop unloading. Now, Samuelson doesn't want anything moved until he checks all the permits on the animals on the other truck individually.
For crying out loud. Okay, I'll handle this, Inspector Samuelson.
All right, just haul it out of the way, clear it in a minute. Clear the way now.
Yeah?
I told you in a minute.
My man, move your elephant.
First of all, I'm not your man.
Then I'll move him for you.
You keep your hands off of her, you understand?
You're the one that doesn't seem to understand.
Buck, I know you're irritated,
but... You stay out of this, Ollie. Fella, this morning... You may be just what the doctor ordered.
What started this? Yeah. Hit him again. Look at that.
You have no idea how pleasant this trip has been since I ditched my entourage in Manila. As the American consul in Singapore, I'd like to welcome you to our country. Thank you. My teacher of geopolitics was very explicit in informing me of the economic importance of Courgeois as it relates to the interests of the United States.
Well, thank goodness. Now you can tell me where you got that glorious outfit.
Bon would tell it. Oh, but don't tell anybody. In the basement. That looks like my welcoming committee. Mr. Buck? Frank?
I'm sorry, Your Highness, but this hooligan here was...
Princess? Princess Cati?
Frank, may I introduce Captain Hayward of the Palace Guard? Captain Frank Buck. Now, will you two please shake hands?
No hard feelings, Mr. Buck.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I guess I had my hard feelings before you even got here. Where's H.H.?
The Sultan sends his regrets, but he'll be tied up with paperwork until the ceremony. Your car is ready whenever you are, Your Highness. I'll send the driver for your luggage.
Gloria, could you give me a hand? That new customs inspector is questioning every one of our shipping permits.
If you'll excuse me, Your Highness, duty call.
I'm sorry to hear about your father.
Thank you, Frank. But my father was very open about his condition in his letters to me. We both knew he was dying.
You not only sound grown up, but you look grown up. My gosh, let me have a look at you.
You know, this is what I came home for. Not the ceremony. You and H.H. and my friends. That's what I remember with goodness.
As we remembered you. But you were a little different with the baseball glove and the pigtails. You weren't exactly the Duchess of Windsor.
Frank, don't make fun of me.
I'm sorry, that's the last thing I'd do. It's just that, you developed into such a beautiful woman, Princess.
You just can't forget that title, can you?
I know a lot of women around here that would like to have it.
I think we'd better go back to the table.
What is it, Kate? What's wrong?
I've changed. And I like the changes. Do you have any idea what it means if I accept my father's crown?
If?
From that moment on, I won't belong to me. I'll be the Sultana. I won't be a woman any longer.
Look, are you sure you don't have just a small case of stage fright?
I don't want to be the Sultana. I want to be me, Frank.
I expect the princess will be up shortly.
Everything is ready. Frank, you'll come to Couchoir with us in the morning?
Princess, I wouldn't miss your coronation for the world.
You haven't listened to me at all, have you?
Listen. You sleep on it. You feel differently in the morning.
I won't feel any different than I feel right now.
On your bath, Your Highness. It's wonderful to have you home. But you must hurry. Captain Hayward plans to leave early in the morning.
I'd forgotten how good you were at giving orders, Marie.
Shh. Hurry now. You need your sleep.
You get in here.
That is not for you to worry. But I worry. When I use my contacts to arrange profitable business agreements, and then I'm left in the dark as to what progress has been made.
Well, when the princess fails to arrive at the appointed hour, the crown will fall to the next in the royal line.
Hamidi, Syed's brother. Then the rubber plantations of Kujwar will be in my hands.
Then I can assure my clients they will receive delivery.
The entire harvest, if they pay the premium.
Ah. Everything dear in this life comes at a premium, Captain. Good night.
He's just ahead. Without a horse, I knew he couldn't outrun us for long.
Bloody beggars, don't they ever sleep? Let me see you bring your horses through here.
Sleep well, Kati.
You've done this since I was a little girl, Marisi. You never change.
Never, my princess.
Good night.
Good night.
Frank, please.
All right. All right.
Lucy, hand me that magazine over there.
Oh, Your Highness, if anything had happened to you.
It's all right, Maurice.
Yeah.
Frank.
I wouldn't complain to Delaney about this. He'd have to provide everyone with a spider.
Thank you. You've saved my life.
For you, my hairy little friend, out. To regret this.
Please, please, I'd like to hire your boat. I have to have a boat. The doghouse, I need you. To see your face again.
Oh, you have perhaps been in an auto accident.
Horses, auto, and otherwise.
So sad. But as you can see, this is not a passenger vessel.
Bundy, I don't care what you're smuggling. I require this craft, and I'm commandeering it.
Smuggling? Oh, no, 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 sir. This is just a native medicine, an elixir. But, Your Highness, this vessel would be much lighter. It would go faster if I attempted to swim ashore.
No, my friend, no. Just start the motor here and bring this craft back into the current. Go ahead. Come on, Bundy.
Your friend. Yes,
I know the throne is a great responsibility. Why, H.H., given his choice, wouldn't have accepted his title. But then, Johor would have gone into bankruptcy if he hadn't.
My uncle Hamidi can run Kujwar. He doesn't need me.
7 miles to a motor ridge. Nice place for an accident. Stay close, driver.
What about about your people?
I mean, they're the ones who pay for your position, luxury, education. Have you ever asked them what they want?
I wasn't given a choice, Frank. I was born to the crown of Cougeoir.
Then wear it with pride. They offer it to you with love and need. By what you do determines what their lives will be. You owe them the very best, Kate.
But I'm not the best.
You can be.
Not if I'm afraid. And I am, Frank.
Pomoto Ridge. Move up closer. Get the signal.
What can that be all about? Maybe he wants you to pull over.
Yes, sir. Should be a spot just up the hill.
She would have made a beautiful sultana. Back to the palace. We'll be the bearer of the sad news. Let's go.
Are you hurt?
Only my dignity. He would land us, I'll have his head.
Spoken like a true sultana. H.H. would be proud of you.
The question is, do we go back to the authorities first, or... Oh, forget that. In Cougeoir, I am the authority. Unless my uncle were to assume the crown in my place. Frank, we must get back to the palace before noon tomorrow.
Sound decision.
Come on.
Glad to see that you made up your mind. But I think it'll be a little faster if we go this way, Your Highness.
That really doesn't sound all that bad.
Come on, if we can make it to the river, hopefully we'll get a boat before nightfall. Get you up to the palace in time for the coronation.
Lead on, Frank.
You okay?
Separated in this fog. 20 minutes earlier, we'd have had some daylight.
Now watch your step.
It appears you're watching for me.
It'd be better if I commanded a royal barge for you. We're gonna have trouble finding a boat. It'd be a lunatic to be out on the river in this pea soup.
But Your Highness, I am not a seeing eye cat.
Shut up, Wendish.
Pardon, Your Highness. You know I would never deliberately abuse your royal personage, but I have no choice.
Talk about a lunatic.
Bundy? Bundy, is that you?
Mr. Buck? Is that you?
Buck? H.H.! What are you doing out on the river? Bundy, get this raft into shore.
Your command is my wish.
Coming, Buck. Bring the bow around, Bundy.
Hey, kids, what the devil? Come on.
Why, H.H., I didn't know this was in your line of work.
Cutty! Good evening, Mr. Buck. It is so nice to see you.
Yeah. Hey, you want to tell me about this, huh?
I've been trying to get this antiquated pile of rubbish back to Singapore.
But Captain Hayward said you were staying at the palace.
Yes, you're Captain Hayward. He and Hamidi planned to kill you, Cutty.
Well, the captain tried well enough.
Oh, I see. He offered me the same favor. That's why I was headed back to Singapore to try to intercept Cutty.
If my Uncle Hamidi tried to kill you, there's no time for Singapore. And if he seizes my crown tomorrow, after that he can't be touched.
You think this thing could get us up to the palace in time?
Oh, Mr. Buck, going downstream in this fog is like a most confused buffalo. And to try to go upstream is to invite...
Be silent, Bundy.
Yes, sir.
Let's give it a go. After all, I owe my cousin Hamidi an appearance at the coronation. Bundy, let's get this raft turned around.
Here yes, you go. Your Highness.
Nothing I like better than a moonlight cruise.
Have the lady board there, Bundy.
Please, give me your fingers.
Couldn't have brought a cabin cruiser, huh?
Well, old boy, can I? Wherever would I have found so select and competent a crew? Hold, Bundy! Come on.
Yes, your
Captain!
The princess.
It didn't go exactly as planned, but I improvised. The princess met with a terrible accident.
A sad coincidence. The Sultan of Johor met the same fate.
Is Von Turgo here yet?
Not till morning.
Then we only have to toast your coronation.
Nearest landing to the palace to be Tana Crossing.
Right. This rig holds up. Another hour should be daylight.
Tana Crossing? That's only a few hours from home.
The palace, yes. Home, no. Not until I settle with Hamidi.
Not to mention Captain Hayward.
Oh, Mr. Buck. Mr. Buck. I do not wish to add to your troubles, but my cargo...
Hang your cargo. It's your neck you should be worried about.
What is this cargo, precisely?
Dynamite.
Dynamite? No, it's too late. Now she's going to blow everybody over the side. Come on!
Shall we sign the documents now, Herr von Turgo?
Before the coronation, Captain?
A minor technicality at this point.
In less than 1 hour, on the 13th stroke of Ramir, I shall be crowned Sultan. As the Captain says, a mere formality.
But I dislike surprises, Captain. There is no possibility of last-minute surprises, is there?
None, Herr von Turgo. Unless you prefer to wait until Lord Hamidi is seated on the throne. It might not be a bad idea at that. A crown sometimes invests a ruler with new insights. What may seem advantageous one day can be found wanting the next.
I see your point. The Sultan.
Sadly, the wall is too high for one so short as me.
We'll handle the walls. It's that guard patrol is going to be a problem.
The first bell of Ramir. We'll never get past them in time.
If Bundy's elixir has remained dry, I should be able to keep them hopping long enough for you and Kati to get into the palace. How's your cricket pitch, old man?
Cricket? With dynamite?
Well, not to worry. You'll get the hang of it. We'll give you time to get into position.
All right. Good luck to you. You too, Bundy.
Everything is in readiness in the Great Hall, Lord Hamidi.
Excellent. 9 more cries of the Great Bell and I shall be the Sultan.
An inopportune question, perhaps, Lord Hamidi, but the people are expecting the princess to take the throne. How will you explain your appearance?
These are simple people, Herr von Turgo. An explanation won't be necessary. But if it is, my answer will quickly reduce the number of questions asked.
I'll throw the first one, shall I?
If you like.
I have a rather nice style. If I do say so, myself. Now. I wouldn't hold on to that too long, old man. Oh.
Passage that leads to the throne room.
Oh, I'm burning myself.
Oh, here.
Left and right.
Yes.
The explosions are coming from every direction.
We'll draw every available man. They must not be allowed to enter the palace.
Yes, sir.
It appears there is some opposition to your scheme, gentlemen.
To annoyance, nothing more.
For the sake of your personal safety and our agreement, I hope you are right.
Right, which way, Kate?
Up the stairs.
But the coronation.
Regrettably, my knowledge of the occasion will be limited to tomorrow's newspaper.
The entrance to the Great Hall is up there. It's where Hamidi and Hayward will be.
All right. Von Turgo! What are you doing here?
I assure you, Mr. Buck, this is no time for explanations.
Okay.
important people waiting for you.
Sultana.
Long may you live in happiness and resplendent good fortune.
Thank you. I know I made the right decision, but there are no words to express the gratitude I feel. Without your help...
Well, come now, all that university education and now you're speechless.
Maybe this will say it better.
I say, come now. Hey, Sultana or not, I mean, this is not quite fair.
Well, after all, H.H., she is your cousin.
Yes.